You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a program that talks about breeding of terrorism and its impact on South Asian nations. Let's begin the headlines first. Indian security forces thwart terrorist attacks in Jammu and Kashmir. Ahead of Independence Day, Punjab police recovers IED grenades dropped by drone near Pakistan border. And zero tolerance for terrorism in all forms needed for enduring Afghan peace, says India at UNSC. The Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir is moving fast towards peace and prosperity. People are happy in the region, but someone is envious of this development. This someone is none other than India's hostile neighbor, Pakistan, which is consistently making efforts to hamper peace and accord in the region. However, the Indian security forces, despite suffering losses, managed to foil all its devious agendas. Recently, proactive Indian defense successfully averted a major terror attack and seized a huge amount of arms and ammunition in the valley, a report.
India's paramilitary border security force in a joint operation along with army and the police recently averted a major terrorist strike before the Independence Day by seizing a huge cache of arms and ammunition from a hideout in Jammu Kashmir's Poonch, while two Hizbul Mujahideen terrorists were arrested from Kishtwar. The seized arms and ammunition include two AK-47 rifles, four AK-47 magazines, one Chinese pistol and 10 pistol magazines, among others. The recovery is significant at a time when there is a high alert of threat across the country ahead of Independence Day. According to intelligence inputs, Pakistan and its intelligence agency ISI have started setting up new terror control rooms in Pak-occupied Kashmir and are also building synergy among terror groups to launch attacks on Jammu and Kashmir ahead of India's Independence Day. However, the Indian security forces in the valley have successfully managed to thwart almost all of their ill designs in the past few weeks. A significant number of terrorists have been eliminated, while many others have been apprehended.
जैसा कि आपको पता होगा कि कुछ दिनों पहले सांबा में हथियारों का एक जखीरा बरामद हुआ. Similarly, आज मेंढर के इलाके में हथियारों का जखीरा बरामद हुआ है. कुछ दिन पहले दो आतंकी दो लड़के जो हैं नौजवान लड़के इन्होंने हिजबुल मुजाहिदीन आतंकी संगठन को ज्वाइन किया था. इस पे हमने काफ़ी ज़ोर शोर से काम करना शुरू किया और तीन चार दिन के अंदर ही हम इन दोनों को अरेस्ट करने में कामयाब हो गए. इनसे भी जो आर्म्स एमिनेशन वगैरह बरामद हुई है. इसके अलावा और भी कई किस्म के इंटेलिजेंस इनपुट्स हैं जिन पर हम काम कर रहे हैं. जो आतंकी संगठन है उनकी कोशिश हमेशा रहती है. अब हमारी जो एफर्ट्स है उसको न्यूट्रलाइज करने में उस पर हम किसी तरह की कमी नहीं रहने देते हैं, जिसका नतीजा है कि जम्मू प्रोविंस में ज़्यादा लड़कों ने मिलिटेंट एक्टिविटीज़ को नहीं ज्वाइन किया और जिसका नतीजा और भी है कि हमने ज़्यादातर जो आर्म्स एमिनेशन की सप्लाई हुई है, चाहे वो ड्रोन के जरिए हो चाहे फिजिकल बॉर्डर पार करके भेजा गया हो, उनको भी हमने इंटरसेप्ट करने में हमें कामयाबी मिली है.
After 2 years of abrogation of Article 370 from Jammu and Kashmir, the region has seen significant development and relative peace. However, Pakistan is turning no stone unturned to create unrest in the valley. Recently, in a massive crackdown on terror, the Indian National Investigation Agency raided 56 locations linked to the banned Jamaat-e-Islami in Jammu and Kashmir as a part of its probe into a terror funding case. The security forces raided the homes of many key Jamaat-e-Islami officials, a considerable amount of incriminating material as well as a laptop and other digital gadgets were discovered, which suggests the presence of a major Pakistan-based terror financing network in the region. According to reports, Jamaat-e-Islami was sourcing funds from terrorist organizations like Hizbul Mujahideen and Jaish-e-Mohammed and was also involved in holding meetings to recruit terrorists in Kashmir. It was collecting the funds domestically and abroad through donations in the name of charity, health and education initiatives. Indian government imposed a ban on Jamaat-e-Islami organization in 2019 due to its pro-Pakistan and pro-separatist activities.
Jamaat-e-Islami is basically an all-out organization which funds, promotes terror. Not only is the funding part, but it also has got madrasas wherein it is brainwashing these small children into picking up and thinking that militancy and jihad is the right thing to do. Now, the money that is coming to this organization was coming in all through Dubai and other sources, and it was being funneled and used for promoting militancy because they were the people who were to distribute this money to Hizbul Mujahideen and other LET and other militant cadres over here in Kashmir.
Frustrated by repeated failures at fomenting terror in Jammu and Kashmir, Pakistan's ISI is now targeting the very system which is designed to look after the well-being of the civilians in the region. The terrorists supported by Pakistan's army and the ISI have attacked a number of local political leaders and several other prominent people in various districts of Jammu and Kashmir. Recently, terrorists associated with Lashkar-e-Taiba shot dead another local leader, Ghulam Rasool Dar, along with his wife, in South Kashmir's Anantnag district this week. Such attacks have witnessed a spike in the last few months. These terrorist attacks are meant not only to cause large-scale damage to life and property, but also to create an atmosphere of fear and terror among the people of Jammu and Kashmir.
Cadre of the militancy, whether it was the top, middle, and now even the bottom, is being scraped off the face of the earth. This has sent shivers down the ISI and the Pakistan establishment. Therefore, what they have done is, they have now been seeing that August 15 is also coming, and August 5, the second anniversary, was celebrated very well in the Kashmir Valley. That has really sent shockwaves amongst them.
Be it deadly terror attacks, illegal drugs or manpower supply, or radicalization of Kashmiri youth, Pakistan has not deferred itself from indulging into anti-Indian activities. Islamabad's decades-long obsession with Kashmir has led to deprivation of food and development in the country. But despite its internal instability, failing economy and international isolation, the country does not compromise when it comes to funding terrorists.
Meanwhile, in India, Punjab State Security Forces foiled a major terror bid as they recovered arms and ammunition in Amritsar city, including a tiffin bomb with 2 kg RDX and IEDs smuggled from across the border using drones. Frustrated by its failures at fomenting trouble in India, Pakistan is using all tricks in its book to unleash violence in the country. But vigilant Indian security forces have been successfully thwarting all its mischievous agendas.
Bleed India with a thousand cuts has always been a state policy of Pakistan against India. Following the same strategy, Pakistan, which has failed miserably at subverting peace in India's Jammu and Kashmir, is now trying to hit India from different corners. Recently, security forces in India's Punjab state foiled a major terror bid as they recovered arms and ammunition in Amritsar city, including pistols, 5 hand grenades and a tiffin bomb with 2 kg RDX and improvised explosive devices smuggled from across the border using drones. According to the report presented by security forces, the IED had 3 initiation mechanisms and a printer circuit board for remote activation, and the bomb would have exploded even on slight mishandling of the tiffin.
Kal shamnu, some recoveries were made in Amritsar rural district, jithe ਸਾਨੂੰ ਕੁਛ ਹੈਂਡ ਗ੍ਰਨੇਡਸ ਰਿਕਵਰ ਹੋਏ ਹੈ, ਕੁਛ ਕੈਟਰੇਜਸ ਰਿਕਵਰ ਹੋਏ ਹੈ, ਐਂਡ ਦ ਮੋਸਟ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਰਿਕਵਰੀ ਇਜ਼ ਆਫ ਆ ਵਾਟ ਵੀ ਕਾਲ ਅ ਟਿਫਿਨ ਬਾਕਸ ਬੰਬ what we will call a improvised explosive device. Our assessment is that this bomb has been delivered through a drone from across the border.
In the recent past, terrorists have upped the game and are using drone technology to infiltrate weapons and attack vital assets and security establishments in India. However, the drone strike at Indian Air Force Base in June this year took things up several notches. India witnessed a glimpse of modern-day drone warfare at two unmanned aerial vehicles or UAVs drop sophisticated improvised explosive device payloads at the Air Force Base in Jammu. In Punjab too, Pakistan-based and sponsored terror groups have been dropping weapons across the international border for some time now. Indian security agencies have in recent months seen increased activity along the international border in Punjab, with the delivery of drugs and ammunition both increasing and the use of drones to make such deliveries possible across the border.
So this is a very sinister development. This is a very, very sinister development. As you are aware, a lot of terrorist hardware, lot of pistols, lot of hand grenades have been coming over the last, you can say, since last 5 years. The present phase of revival of terrorism, it started with the Fidayeen attack on Dinanagar police station in June of 2015. Then we had an attack on Pathankot Air Base. And this, then we had targeted killings in 2016 and also 17, as you are aware. After that, a lot of modules have been busted from time to time, and recoveries, huge recoveries of weapons, pistols, revolvers, AK-47s, MP9 rifles, guns, etc. have been made. Explosives, detonators, all this has been coming. And we have seen that in the recent past, maybe over the last 2 months, 3 months, there has been increased activity from across the border. So with drones, with this new technology, it is a big security challenge.
As per security forces, foreign-based pro-Khalistani entities like Sikhs for Justice, working in close collaboration with the ISI, are trying to inflict heavy damage on India. On various occasions, the band Sikhs for Justice has made automated phone calls issuing threats to Indian journalists and politicians, asking them to mend their ways or face consequences. Once again, an unverified audio message allegedly by SFJ's Gurbatwan Singh Pannu from an international phone number was circulated claiming to an ex-Punjab and Delhi from India.
We are campaigning to liberate Punjab from Indian occupation. Once we have Khalistan, we will annex Delhi and we will raise Khalistan flag on red throat. Everyone in Delhi has a choice. Stay with us or move on.
The support for Khalistan in India has sunk very low, but terror groups like Sikhs for Justice have been pushing their agenda hard through various platforms with the help of Pakistan's ISI. The pro-Khalistan agenda for a separate homeland has no takers in Punjab, but the cause still survives in Pakistan, where jihadist groups have made common cause with Sikh separatists against their shared enemy, India.
Let's move to Afghanistan, where the Taliban has intensified its military campaign, seizing vital towns and districts in different parts of the country. The deeply distressing videos coming from Afghanistan show civilians being beaten, tortured and murdered. These videos clearly unveil the Taliban's true behavior and the world they are determined to make for the citizens. Analysts now fear that capital Kabul could fall to the Taliban within weeks, a report.
This recently emerged video shows Taliban militants dragging a body of a man in the ground and shooting at him. The area where the incident took place is believed to be the city of Farah in western Afghanistan. Taliban members are now ousting civilians from their homes and brutally killing them. Recently, a young woman in Afghanistan was also killed by these Islamists for wearing tight clothes and not being accompanied by a male relative in northern Balkh province. On one hand, Taliban are indiscriminately killing civilians, and on the other hand, the insurgent group is seizing all the major cities of the country. Recently, Taliban claimed to have seized control of Pule Khumri, the largest city in Baghlan province.
الحمد لله على طلب فكامل نصر سرا ودخل المسلم ولس بكرة وجوه مكاري سرا بقدر بدخول ولايات سكوت ولايات أمن قمانداني وزي سينا ونسا ترها وزي دو تر قمانداني تر أين تر كلاجيت اللواء فوري مكمل منطقة حصولا دشمن زلينا و دشمن سرا هيد صوت هم كان نو ولس مصر و هذا ولس أمكاري وترى ترى كامل سرتو ده المجاهدون فلش مقاومة سرا فلش قرباني سرا
The United Nations has warned that the war in Afghanistan has entered a new, deadlier, and more destructive phase, as the Taliban forces have made dramatic advances, staking claim to some provincial capitals. The speed of their advance has shocked the US government and its allies. According to US intelligence assessment, Taliban fighters could isolate Afghanistan's capital in 30 days and possibly take it over within 3 months. Hence, residents in Kabul are losing their hope.
اگر میخواین در سیاست شریک شوان از راه مصالحه باید در حکومت شریک شوان نه از طریق زور و از طریق تفنگ و از طریق حملات که باعث ویرانگری هم خود وطن میشه هم ملت میشه
Thousands of Afghans are fleeing Taliban captured cities, many telling of brutal treatment by the insurgents. As per reports, girls are being kidnapped to become Taliban brides and young men are being press-ganged into fighting. In such a critical situation, Afghan government has its eye on Pakistan. Kabul insists that Pakistan's support for the Taliban is a major factor for the militants being able to mount their campaign that threatens to overrun Afghanistan. Scores of Afghan social media users and victims of Pakistan's atrocities have thus started trending sanction Pakistan to draw the world's attention towards Pakistan's involvement in supporting and fortifying the Taliban.
Pakistan has been committing all sorts of atrocities both inside Pakistan against Pashtuns and Sindhis and Baloch, as well as overseas through plotting against the killing of exiled activists and journalists such as Karima Baloch in Canada and journalist Sajid Hussain in Sweden. It is not hidden from the world, it has also been involved in mass atrocities in Afghanistan and India through adding the Taliban and other terrorist groups and their terrorist activities. The UN must sanction Pakistan as its sponsorship of terrorism has already cost the lives of thousands of innocent people.
Next few weeks in Afghanistan could be decisive. Hence, Pakistan should stop looking to leverage the Taliban, and the insurgent group should be given a strong and clear signal. Fighting must stop now, and parties must negotiate. Otherwise, there may be nothing left to win.
Under the current presidency of India, the UN Security Council recently held a meeting to discuss the Afghanistan situation amid increasing military offensive by the Taliban as US forces withdraw from the war-torn country. Stressing that the future of Afghanistan cannot be its past, New Delhi at the meeting emphasized that it is time for the Council to decide on actions to ensure the immediate cessation of violence in the country. We take a look.
In the past few weeks, the war in Afghanistan has taken a destructive phase. The Taliban has been gaining its hold across Afghanistan by resorting to widespread violence. With the Islamic fundamentalist group targeting innocent civilians and government officials, the security situation in the war-torn country is worsening. Hence, the United Nations Security Council under the presidency of India recently held an urgent meeting to discuss and take stock of Afghan crisis. India's permanent representative to the UN, T.S. Tirumurthy, urged members in the crucial meeting to call for an end to violence and hostilities and helped reveal to the outside world the dire situation in Afghanistan.
The rapid deterioration of the security situation in Afghanistan constitutes a serious threat to regional peace and stability. It is therefore time for the international community, and in particular this council, to take stock of the situation and decide on actions that would help bring a permanent and comprehensive ceasefire and ensure an immediate cessation of violence. Anything short of this will constitute a serious threat to regional peace and security.
The Security Council on Afghanistan last met in June, but the situation in the conflict-ridden country has rapidly worsened since then. The peace talks that had started between the Taliban and the Afghan government last year in Doha have not made significant progress. On one hand, the situation is so tense in Afghanistan, and on the other hand, Pakistan-backed terrorists in the country are engaging in carrying out the proxy war. Recently, Pakistani parliamentarian Mohsin Dawar himself nailed the role of his nation in exporting Taliban terrorists to Afghanistan. In fact, Islamabad's assistance to the Afghan Taliban was one of the causes for the US failure in Afghanistan, as it managed to play a double game with the US and Taliban. Therefore, in the UN Security Council meeting, Ambassador and Permanent Representative of Afghanistan to the UN, Ghulam Issakhzai, stated that Pakistan should help Afghanistan in dismantling the Taliban for peace to prosper in the war-torn country.
Consistent with the agreement of the leadership of Afghanistan and Pakistan in Tashkent last month, we urge Pakistan to help with removing and dismantling of Taliban sanctuaries and supply line and establish with us a joint monitoring and verification mechanism to make the fight against terrorism and international effort for peace effective and credible. Let me reiterate here that Afghanistan desires nothing but friendly relation and peaceful coexistence with Pakistan based on mutual respect for each other's sovereignty.
Pakistan's nexus with the Afghan Taliban is not new. Islamabad has been providing military and intelligence aid to the Afghan Taliban and its vicious Haqqani branch in Pakistan for years. This unholy nexus has resulted in the deaths of US soldiers, Afghan security personnel and civilians, plus significant destabilization of Afghanistan. Hence, in a veiled reference to Pakistan, India at the UN Security Council meet demanded accountability from those responsible for emboldening extremists.
For enduring peace in Afghanistan, terrorist safe havens and sanctuaries in the region must be dismantled immediately and terrorist supply chains disrupted. It needs to be ensured that Afghanistan's neighbors and the region are not threatened by terrorism, separatism and extremism. There needs to be zero tolerance for terrorism in all its forms and manifestations. It is equally important to ensure that the territory of Afghanistan is not used by terrorist groups to threaten or attack any other country. Those providing material and financial support to terrorist entities must be held accountable.
The Afghans are exhausted by war and yearn for peace. Hence, there is an urgent need to bring the population relief from relentless violence. With Afghanistan at a dangerous turning point, the United Nations Security Council under the presidency of India must seize the current opportunity to prevent the crisis from spilling across national borders.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We will be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@nin.com. This is Karim Zimik signing off on behalf of the entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.
subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.